Tell you what, maybe I'll just do a video about this. Casey Neistat. I don't know if that's the way you pronounce his last name. Huge fan of his. Love his work. I'm actually trying to make my videos kind of like his in certain ways. You know, like for instance, when he does this. See, like he does this when he goes to the different area, a different corner, like he bends down and talks to the camera. That it makes his scene looks more professional, you know, like he has cameras in every corner. It seems really, really cool.
I really hate that the toilet is this close to the tub. Even though I don't even use the tub, but I just hate that right there. I mean, if I was using the tub, I would hate it more. But I definitely hate it so much.
I don't know if you guys brush your teeth before taking a shower, but I brush it after. I'm not really sure. It's one of those things that I'm not sure that people do. You know, I just always brush my teeth after taking the shower. So, I found that post on Instagram. And I just feel very passionate about it. You know what I'm saying? Like, as a theist and as a Muslim, I want to talk about it. I got a lot of strong views against it, you know, against that post. You know, some fucking idiot on Instagram posted it. Some atheist. You know, you could believe or disbelieve whatever you want. But to post things like that, like you know, like you know for sure that that's the reasons people believe, you know, the existence of God. You're such an idiot. You have no idea. You're so ignorant against what many theists actually have for reasons to believe in a deity. And that's my point. So, I'm actually considering keeping the shades on every time I'm doing this with you guys, like, making a video. Because, you know, Casey Neistat, I still can't pronounce his last name. Neistat? Casey suggests that wearing the shades makes you look more professional. Not because of the shades, but because when you're doing this, like when you're recording yourself, you're not looking at the screen. It makes you look like you're looking straight at the camera all the time. And I have the tendency to look at the screen a lot. So it kind of comes off unprofessional. And I guess, you know, he does have a point. So I'm probably going to keep the chains on all the time. Not all the time, but when I'm recording myself. Okay, so before I start the video, the video been started. Before I start the topic, or my today's topic, we're gonna change all this. We're gonna take this, we're gonna put it there, we're gonna take that, we're gonna put it there, we're gonna take that, we're gonna put it there, for no reason at all, just because my wife feels like it. And this is like every 2-3 months. Why do women have this urge of changing things that's perfectly alright? You know? I don't understand it. That makes no absolute sense. It makes no I'm just tired. Tired. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. Is it a BMP? The BMP. So, this is a comprehensive review. No. That's a reference to Casey Neistat. I think that's how it's pronounced. Whatever. Casey. But, no, this is not a comprehensive review. What it is, hopefully it is a comprehensive, short explanation to the reasons why theists believe in a god. Which is the position that I'm going to take as a theist, not as a Muslim, which is I am a Muslim, but I won't take that position because believing in a religion and believing in a god is kind of separate in a sense. You will get that sense in a minute. But let's start. Okay, so I apologize for the noise that's around me right now, but I have no other choice but to make this video here. And there's nowhere else I can go. So please try to ignore the noise. I do apologize. Okay, so what is the reasons for my belief in a god? It's really simple, and it is like a prior reasoning, right? It's basically observing something and saying, "Hey, you know, the most rational thing that you can think of." I'll give you an example. Looking at a light bulb. Once you look at a light bulb, you won't think that the light bulb just came into existence. You won't think anything else. Because you automatically know that the light bulb is man-made and it was put there by someone. Okay, so that's a prior reasoning. It's really as simple as that. So, basically, when I look at everything that's around me, I look at the functionality, for instance, of the tree. A tree provides oxygen. There's a process called photosynthesis. And this process is when a tree provides us oxygen for us to live on this earth. Without trees, we cannot live, okay? So there's this process. There's information. There's a functionality. There's reason. Now, taking those into consideration, I can only assume that it must be a higher intelligent being that created this functionality, created these processes, and created this tree. Now, going back to the tree, right? What did it come from? Why is it that way? Why is there many different trees of these random mutations? I mean, was there a common ancestry, right? Because there are different species of tree. Was there a one point, one tree that somehow ejaculated and spread his seeds all over the world? And that's why you see all these different types of plants. Huh? That's the reason that the tree ejaculated on earth? All around the field and inside the walls and I don't know. So, why would it? No. On the floor and ground and seeds. So you get my point. I'm trying to say it's really as simple as this. Like, information equals intelligence. There's intelligence, therefore there's information. There's information, therefore there must be an intelligence. Coming back to the books, right? The Holy Scriptures, Revelations. It's separate. It's absolutely separate. You have to believe that there is a deity first before you believe in the revelations. Okay? So you believe in a deity. You believe that there must be a god because of all this information. Then you search for any type of symbol or sign that's from God. And you read these scriptures or because they claim to be revelations from God. And you try to come to your conclusions, which is my conclusion that the Quran is absolutely the revelation of God. It makes total sense and it actually connects all religions around us. It connects everything. It makes total sense of everything. Okay? And, okay, so atheists, there are a lot of atheists that believe in, you know, they have their reasons to disbelieve. There's different type of reasons why they disbelieve in a god. But, you know, one of them that I know of, and they're all subjective to me as a theist, they're all atheist reasons for disbelieving in a god is always a subjective reason. It's nothing, it has to do nothing with logic or rationality. It's really just because they feel like God is immoral or God is egotistical, which absolutely makes no damn sense. Why wouldn't God not be egotistical? He's God. He's the almighty being. There's nothing like him. He's the greatest that ever exists. He is the almighty. How can you not be egotistical? Like, makes no sense. But there are reasons they say, well, you know, evidence are is evolution. There's no evidence, right? Evolution is a process. So their reasons to disbelieve in God is actually our reasons to believe in there is a God. There's evolution. Evolution is a process where all species go through to survive in a certain environment, is that adaptation to a certain environment. And that is a process. That is a functionality. That is why we believe there must be an intelligence. But for them, that is a process. That is a functionality. But there's no reason for there to be an intelligence. Fucking, what kind of dumbass logic is that? Listen, guys, I have nothing against atheists or anyone else. Like, you could believe whatever you want. What I have is the problem is with that photo, with that post, and that's the only problem that I have with that people or atheists, some atheists will assume that, you know, atheists believe in God because of a book. I mean, it's the most logical sense, honestly. It's the most rational thing you could ever believe, that there is a God, than to believe that everything just hocus-pocus came into existence. It makes no damn sense. Okay? Zero does not equal one. One must have always existed for there to be another one. You know what I'm saying? Like, it makes no sense. Also, the Spider-Man comic book, like, what is the point of that? What is the, what are you talking about? Because Spider-Man the comic book exists, so therefore Spider-Man exists? That is so freaking stupid. Like, it's idiotic. Why? Because when you think about it, you know, Stan Lee created Spider-Man. But if you don't, let's just say that, you know, let's just take the book, the comic book, and take, like, ignore or disregard that information that Stan Lee created Spider-Man, right? So we find this book or this claim. Let's say the claim. There is a claim that there is a Spider-Man out there. But you never seen Spider-Man. What reason would you disbelieve his existence? Because you haven't seen him? Or because it's so crazy that a man would have abilities that a spider possessed? Hello, use your freaking logic, boy. Like, take the science into conclusion, evolution. Okay, we all share a common ancestry, right? Like, we all share some type of chromosomes, genetics, with other species in the world. So how can it, why wouldn't it be impossible for a human being to share that genome with a spider, to have that genome in his system out of random mutations? Okay, so that's, that argument is so freaking pathetic. So that is it for today, guys. So I'm out. Peace. Ah, shit, I can't do it right. Peace.